In this video, we will take the second application of Kolrach's law, in which we are calculating degree of dissociation alpha. We are calculating alpha means what? Degree of dissociation, which formula is what? Alpha is equal to molar conductance at given concentration divided by molar conductance at infinite dilution, isn't it? Infinite dilution. This is at infinite dilution. This is at given dilution, or given concentration, or given dilution. Both you can take here. Now this lambda naught m, generally we calculate by using the Kolrach's law. Lambda naught m is equal to, what is the formula? Lambda of cation plus lambda of anion. Whereas molar conductance at given dilution or given concentration formula will be K into 1000 by molarity. Okay. Now in this case, next dissociation constant Ka also we can calculate by using the degree of dissociation only. We can calculate the dissociation constant's formula is what? C alpha square into 1 minus alpha. Now substitute the alpha formula. Alpha is equal to, substitute here, lambda m by lambda naught m. In this, if you substitute, what happen? We get this formula. But no need this formula. Directly you calculate alpha once, substitute the alpha value here only. So this formula is no need for us. Simply substitute alpha here and here, you will get the dissociation constant. We'll solve a problem by using these equations. Right, we'll take one problem here. So in this, first the given concentration is what? This is the concentration given. Specific conductance or conductivity is given. This one, conductivity is given. How much conductivity is? 4.95 into 10 to the power of minus 5. Similarly, molar conductance at infinite dilution is given. Molar conductance at infinite dilution is also given. For what actually? Acetic acid. CH3COOH is weak acid. So for that, we are using Kolrach's law. So what is the data they given? Concentration given, molar conductance at infinite dilution is given, and specific conductance also given. Now what they are asking to calculate? Dissociation constant Ka they are asking. Ka is equal to, formula will be C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. To calculate dissociation constant, what we need? Alpha we need. Now alpha formula will be molar conductance at given volume or given concentration divided by molar conductance at infinite dilution. So this value is given. How much they will given actually? 390.5. This is given. So once if we calculate lambda m, we get the alpha, right? Now first we calculate lambda m formula, K into 1000 by m. Now K value will be what? 4.95 into 10 to the power of minus 5 into 1000. I have taken 10 to the power of 3, and molarity, that means concentration, I have taken. This concentration I am taking what? In terms of what? Like this, 0.001028, I am taking 1.028 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Now here minus 3 get cancelled, we get minus 2. Minus 2 10 to the power of 3 will becomes like this. Now 4.95 into 10 by 1.028. Now if you do this calculation part, we are going to get roughly around 49 point something we get here. We'll do this one. 4.95 divided by 1.028. Exactly, we are going to get 48.1. This value we are going to get what? 48.1 you are going to get here. This is what? Lambda m here. So now we calculate now alpha now here. Alpha is equal to, we are going to calculate. Alpha lambda m, how much we got? 48.1 we got. Next, lambda naught is given. 390.5 is given. Now if you do the calculation part again, 48.1 divided by 390.5. That is equal to 0.123. Okay, we got a fancy number, 0.123. This is the alpha value. We got alpha value. Now what we have to calculate now? Dissociation constant Ka, that equal to C alpha square 1 minus alpha. C is how much here actually? 1.028 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 1.028 into 10 power minus 3 into alpha. How much we got? This is alpha, no? Shall I write like this? 0.123, I'm writing 1.23 into 10 to the power of minus 1. 0.123, I'm writing 1.23 into 10 to the power of minus 1. Again, this is what? Whole square. This will be the whole square. Now, alpha equal to how much we are going to get here? Same thing, no? 1.23 into 10 to the power of minus 1. 1 minus alpha. Okay, 1 minus alpha here. Now, if you do the calculation part here, isn't it? 1 minus 1.23 into 10 to the power of minus 1, 1.028. Here we are going to get 1.78 into 10 to the power of minus 5 will be the dissociation constant here. Next, one more problem if you take care what? The molar conductivity again, lambda m is given 46.1 is given. Now, concentration is given 0.025 is given. Now they given lambda naught H plus that equal to 349.6, lambda naught of Cl minus that equal to CS3CO minus that is 54.6. Now lambda naught of CS3COOH is equal to, according to Kolb-Rasch law, we can write lambda naught H plus lambda naught of CS3COO minus. Now lambda H plus is given how much? 349.66 plus 54.6. If you add this one, you are going to get 404.2. This is what? Lambda naught M of acetic acid. Now what they are asking here, degree of dissociation and dissociation constant. Now alpha will be is equal to lambda m by lambda naught m, right? Lambda naught m. Lambda m they given already 46.1. Lambda naught m we got 404. That value will be 0.11. This value will be what? 0.11. Alpha equal to 0.11 here. Now K is equal to what? Dissociation constant. K is equal to what? Dissociation constant is equal to what we are going to get? C into alpha square by 1 minus alpha. C is how much here? 0.025 into alpha square 0.11 whole square divided by 1 minus. We are going to get here, if you do this calculation part, we are going to get roughly around 0.00033 we are going to get here. So you can write that one as 3.3 into 10 to the power of how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 4 here. This will be the dissociation constant. Similarly, we have some more problems or homework. You can take homework here. Again, concentration is given. K is given. Okay. Now calculate its molar conductivity. You can calculate molar conductivity by using K into 1000 by molarity. And lambda naught is given. How much given? 390.5 is given. What you have to calculate? Dissociation constant we have to calculate. For this we need what? Alpha also we need to calculate. So one more problem also given, same problem. So you take this is also assignment, and this one also what? Assignment questions here. Okay, with this what happened? Kolb-Rasch